So we're discussing SVG graphics today because in just a few minutes we're going to ask you to create this PI graphic web part and then associate that with an SVG file that you've saved from ProcessBook. As you see here, here's the ProcessBook display. I created it in ProcessBook, and there's an option within ProcessBook to do a save as SVG. So as you can see, that's one of the formats that we support. Now when I save this as an SVG, let me go ahead and save it again. I'm just putting it into my documents. It's called main column bottom.svg. I can close it and open it back up as that SVG. In fact, it's been saved now as a different display entirely, so I can close out of this book. Let me go ahead and open. I'll choose SVG. You'll notice all the things that are normally associated with a PI trend, the things you can see on a display, are supported. So trends, bar graphs, values. Now the one thing that's not supported within the SVG format is any of the Visual Basic scripting that may be associated with that display. Normally those are only stored in the PDI format. Now if you're curious as to what actually got saved, if we go out and take a look at that file, open it up in Notepad, you'll notice that it's just pure kind of an XML format here. So it's pure ASCII. It's one of those formats that works well on the web. So and that's how we create that file, that SVG file. Now again, we're going to use this later on when we bring this into the PI graphic web part inside PI web parts.